Hey there, fellow travelers. Mark here with Walter's Mobile. We're in the Mercado Central here in San Jose, getting ready to have a nice little snack at one of the sodas. And what I thought I'd tell you is what you should eat when you are here in Costa Rica. But it's a little bit loud here, so let's go to a much quieter place to learn what you should eat when you are here in Costa Rica, because it's fantastic. And always have an Imperial when you do enjoy a fantastic rice and beans or whatever you have here in Costa Rica.
So we've left the Mercado Central in the downtown area. So what should you eat when you are here in Costa Rica? Let's get started. Now, the first thing you need to know is rice and beans are a staple of Costa Rican culture and Costa Rican food. Costa Ricans will eat rice and beans literally three times a day. Breakfast, yes, breakfast, rice and beans, lunch and dinner, okay? Now the breakfast one, because you'll probably come in at night and you get up in the morning, you'll see rice and beans for breakfast. The thing is, rice and beans gets mixed together in the morning into a dish called gallo pinto. And gallo pinto is rice and beans mixed together with some onion and probably some cilantro. And then they'll have maybe some cream on the side you'll mix with it. You might have some eggs with it on the side and stir that all together. It is the quintessential Costa Rican breakfast. You have to have that. Now, most places will have other options out there for you. Fruit is definitely a must. There's so much fresh fruit for breakfast. But gallo pinto is the quintessential Costa Rican breakfast. You have to have that. Now, after you've had your breakfast rice and beans, it's time for you to have your lunch and your dinner. And you have the most typical Costa Rican dish out there. It's called casado, married, okay, or marriage, okay? Casado is rice and beans, but they're not together. See, we separate them. See, like to mix it up a bit. They're rice, a side of rice, a side of beans, and then you have like a salad with it, and then it will either come with maybe steak or chicken or pork or fish, and you'll have that. And there'll be like fried plantains on the side. Plantains are like bananas, little cut up fried bananas and stuff like that. And it is just one of those things you have to have when you're here, and you might have it for lunch and dinner and just switch it up. It's great, okay? So that rice and beans, it's a definite when you're here. Now, what are some other things you're gonna have when you're here? Well, let's look at some kind of like appetizers you might wanna have, or smaller dishes. Well, one thing you wanna have is ceviche. And we have ceviche in the US, so you can find that lots of places, but basically it's little diced up pieces of fish or lobster or sometimes green mango. Oh, it's so awesome. And it's put into kind of like lime juice and stuff like that with some onions and tomatoes, and it kind of cooks in the with the acid of all the citrus fruits and stuff like that, the juice in there, and you have that. It is very good. I definitely recommend it, especially on the coast. Other little snacks you might have, chicharrones. Now, chicharrones are like those, and you look on the menu, it'll say like pork rinds. It's not like traditional pork rinds like you see in the US in a bag. This is really like crispy pieces of pork, and it is phenomenal, okay? You definitely want to have that when you're here. If you like, if you go to Germany and you have like the Schweinshaxe, the pork knuckle, it kind of tastes like that. It is awesome. You have to have chicharrones. Another thing you might want to have when you're looking for a kind of a snack thing is you'll see them bring you a lot of chips and bean dip. Yes, the bean dip here is actually very good, and you should definitely have some when you're here. Another kind of smaller dish you might want to try is called patacones. And patacones, basically what it is, it's a smashed up plantain, and they smash it to like a little pancake, and they cook it so it's nice and crispy. They'll put a little bit of the bean dip sauce on there, some cheese, and then you have either some meat on top of it, and you eat it kind of like a tostada. It is phenomenal. Definitely a must try. The kids were kind of like worried about it at first because they didn't understand the fried plantain at the bottom, but it is really good, okay? Like a plantain chip. Oh, it was phenomenal. You gotta have it. Now, if you want to have like a little mix of things out there, you can have what's called a picada. And picada is like a little, you know, little pinches of things. So you might get a little bit of the pork rind stuff, the chicharrones, or a little bit of ceviche, or a little bit of fried fish, or a little bit of camarones or shrimp on it. That's a nice little snack to have when you are on the way. Also, when you're looking for like a quick eat, what you're going to see is there's, you know, in the bigger cities, they do have the US fast food places. But the fast food that seems to kind of be very popular here is fried chicken. You'll see a lot of places on the side of the road selling fried chicken, and it is very good and well worth having. Now, let's go into some of the bigger meals you're gonna have when you're here. I talked about casado already. So you have the rice dishes. Now, the rice dishes here, it's arroz is rice, and you'll see arroz con, rice with, and it can be with many different things. Arroz con camarones, it's rice with shrimp. Arroz con pollo is rice with chicken. Now the thing is, these dishes are much more, it's rice with a little bit of chicken, rice with a little bit of shrimp. If you want more chicken than rice, you need to have pollo con arroz, chicken with rice, okay? But just know a lot of the sodas that are out here, they're gonna sell arroz con, the rice dish kind of thing. Now, when you want to go to eat here. You can eat at your resorts and stuff like that, but those prices are very high. What I do recommend is you go to restaurants called sodas. And sodas are your quintessential Costa Rican dining experience. You have to go do it. You can take your kids, all kinds of stuff. It's really quite the experience. So eat there. Now, some other things you want to have is olla de carne, which is like a beef stew. And you'll see when you're here, there's a lot of really good soups that are here, especially with mariscos. Mariscos are seafood, okay? And that's one thing you gotta really have when you are here is the white elephant out there is the seafood. It is phenomenal here. Sea bass is great. We had trout last night, which was great. You're gonna have mahi-mahi. You have so much great fish that's here, but also the shrimp. You'll see lobster stuff. You'll see all kinds of great seafood here. Definitely eat it. I mean, they've got two coasts, and so you're gonna have fresh fish no matter where you are in the country. So eat that up. No matter what, if you're not sure what to get the fish, you will be fine. It is phenomenal here, okay? Now, also, when we're looking at phenomenal stuff, you're looking at the fresh fruit. The fresh fruit here, mangoes, papaya, pineapple. Look, the pineapple in the U.S., a lot comes from Costa Rica. The thing is, they pick it here and it ripens on the way to the grocery store. Here, when you in the U.S. at least, when you're eating it here, they picked it fresh and it is so much sweeter and so much juicier. Oh my God, I'm drooling just thinking about the fruit, the pineapple, the mangoes, the papayas. You definitely have to have those, okay? And eat those for breakfast, lunch, dinner, whenever you can have it, have it. There's these things called fruterias where you can go get fruit anytime and it's really good. Now, another thing with that fruit you want to have is you want to have the refrescos. You want to have the drinks made of, you know, the fresh juice drinks, and they'll make it out of papaya or guayanaba, or they'll make it out of pineapple or, you know, watermelon. I mean, it's so fresh that they make into these juices, and yes, you have them at your soda, you know, they'll have them at the sodas and stuff like that, and you have them, and it's really as you drink it and you feel refreshed from it, and it is just the most another quintessential thing you have to drink when you are here. Now, other things you might want to look at in terms of drinking, what are we going to drink when you're here? Well, coffee. I mean, Costa Rica is famous for its coffee. I hate coffee. I mean, I literally hate coffee. I've actually had 3 cups here. Me, I hate coffee, but I love the coffee here. It is actually very smooth. It's not the bitterness you can have with milk or whatever. It is really good, but coffee is a definite must when you are in Costa Rica. Other things to drink when you're here is, hey, guess what? You can drink the water here in Costa Rica. Pretty much everywhere in the entire country, the water is safe to drink. Now, if you don't feel comfortable drinking it, you don't have to. They have bottled water. And when you ask for water at the restaurant, they'll say, do you want, you know, de casa or botella? Do you want it from the house or from the bottle? So you say de casa, it's from the house. So that's tap water here, okay? But you can drink it no problem, so that's good. Other things you can drink, yes, they have all the international sodas here, so you're fine with that. But some of the quintessential stuff is pipa fria, which is coconut water. They, you know, chop off the top of the coconut and you drink it with a straw out of there. And the other thing you might want to try, if you can find it, it's called chan. Chan is like these little seeds they put into the water, they pour the hot water and mix it up and chill it a little bit. And it's kind of like drinking brains or snot or something. It's really kind of a weird texture, but definitely a quintessential Costa Rican thing. I actually really liked it. One of my kids did. The other one was like, what is this I'm drinking? It was pretty funny. But honestly, chan, if you can get it, is well worth trying because it is another quintessential thing. That seems to be the word today. Now, in terms of the alcohol you're going to come here, there's a few beer brands. You've got Bavaria, you've got, you know, Pilsen, but the biggest one out there, and you'll see it everywhere with its Phoenix logo, is Imperial. It's got a yellow bottle on there. You'll see it all over the country. It actually is pretty good. That's what we've been drinking. Obviously, Ron Centenario, or the rum here, is very good. Homemade Guado, which is like a homemade sugarcane liquor. That's another thing you might have to drink here as a little shot afterwards. And that kind of brings us to the desserts. What are you going to have for dessert here in Costa Rica? Well, obviously have a coffee if you want to have something. And the fruits are really good. But the tres leches cake, the 3 milk cake, is a must when you're here. It is so sweet and so delectable. And they have it pretty much everywhere around the country. You're going to love that. And if you get a chance, try some Costa Rican ice cream. If you want to get the pre-packaged stuff, you have Dos Pinos, which my kids have really enjoyed. And then there's a chain of ice cream places called Pops. If you go to Pops, have like the mango ice cream or papaya ice cream, because it's made with fresh fruit from here in Costa Rica, and it is just phenomenal. Anyway, I am super hungry now after filming this video, so I'm gonna go eat some more. It's morning, so I'm gonna have some gallo pinto to start my day. I hope you have a great time here in Costa Rica. If you wanna learn more, 10 things that'll shock you about coming to Costa Rica, 5 things you'll love and hate, check us out on our website at waltersworld.com. We're also on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all those kind of things out there. We appreciate all your likes and subscriptions, and have a great time in Costa Rica. And eat well, but I know you will. Adios.